What's up, my friends? Toby Wayne from Toby Wayne Studios. So here is the head form that I sculpted up yesterday. It was just the head form, and then I went ahead and just turned him into a zombie. So tonight, I'm going to do a quick paint job on this zombie here. And I'm going to try to keep it more flesh tones and maybe some blacks. I kind of like that look. So let's just jump right in here. I'm going to start with my flesh tones. Always do a nice couple of base coats of flesh. And I'm hoping that this video records. I had a little bit of an issue yesterday with the painting of Peanut. For some reason, I was recording the whole thing, and then I went to go check on the footage, and I literally had a 1 minute and 50 seconds, I believe, of the final section of the painting of Peanut, where I was just glossing his eyes. So disheartening at best, because I was moving through that thing pretty darn quick, because I wanted to show everybody kind of what it was like to paint something like that up. But I'm hoping that this video will capture. We'll see. And I actually shot a video of me sculpting this little guy, and I did go back and do some changes after the fact. So he doesn't quite look like what you're seeing here, but that's okay. I think you guys get the gist of it. And my goal, again, with doing these one-offs is just to do very quick sculpts, but keep the quality up, but move fairly quick, and to do pretty quick paint jobs on these little guys. And they're not going to be super expensive. I just want to do practice work here, so let me get my little blow dryer. This helps speed the process up, of course. Flick a nice paintbrush of paint onto my pants. That's always nice. So I'm going to go ahead and do a quick second paint coat of the flesh tones to get into all the little cracks and crevices and to make sure I've got a nice base to work off of so that the paint doesn't want to lift up when I'm doing my water wash. Hoping this video helps out those that are looking to do some painting, to get into painting. I am by no means an expert at painting. I do what I can. This is all, I didn't go to school or class to learn how to paint or sculpt. I just kind of did my own thing with the clays, and that's a story I'll have to share in a future video. I did start sculpting when I was in high school, but it was an interesting circumstance. So I'll tell that story in a future video, because I know I've had several people ask me how I got into sculpting, and I always enjoy telling that story. And my wife, God bless her, is sick of hearing it, so sorry, Katie. See a couple little spots that I missed. Okay. All right. So there's my first flesh tone. And you know what? I think I'm going to go with a touch of Bambi Brown just to do a nice little wash on him, because I really don't want to make him too fleshy. I want to get a little bit of depth darkness to him. And just the slightest wash, just to get into all those little cracks and crevices. And I think I'm gonna just go ahead and do him a quick little pat down here. This will kind of help speed the processes up. So that just kind of got the first layer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring my nasty gunky water, which, you know, hey, we do what we have to, you know. This actually is lending to the painting processes by doing a nice little darkening here. So I'm going to go ahead and just do some nice washes in these little cracks and crevices. And this Bambi Brown is just subtle enough of a difference between the flesh that I just laid down and what this Bambi Brown is, so that I can actually start doing some darkening here, and it'll be just different enough that I can do my washes. And it'll lend to a nice modeling job too, I think. My goal is to just do all the deep recessed areas, gums, tissues, all up inside of the torn skin area. Very subtle stuff, very subtle, but it gets the point across when we get to the end here. You'll see what happens, I'm hoping. We'll see. And it may not look like much now, but the more layers that I start to apply, the deeper and darker those areas will start to they'll start to show up a little better. I'm going to go ahead and blast this real quick. More layers. And I actually, to be honest with you, I actually prefer to use just one or two colors when it's at all possible. It's amazing what you can accomplish with just simple, just a simple wash, just with multiple buildups is pretty amazing. You'd be surprised. And then, of course, you can kind of start dabbing on sections and to do, you know, the more layers you can start modeling and all that good stuff by just applying these little washes of one color. That's it. But I'll show you kind of what's going to happen here. And this is kind of I think the infection site where he got bit, maybe. Just to kind of start doing some washing out around those bite areas. Show a little bit of infection. Also, you can use these washes to get into your neck areas here to do shadows and depth for muscle tones and all that good stuff. Always like to get into the little recessed areas there. Yeah, this is going to be like a fleshy browns, possibly black. We'll see. I do like black goo coming out of the mouth, so we may end up going that route. Come on, come on, blow dry. For some reason, his left eye there doesn't want to really dry, and I think it's because it's such a deep socket that the water pools up inside of there and doesn't want to do that. So I can actually remove a portion of that by just taking my brush and just kind of gently wiping that area out. Okay, let's go back and do some more. See how it's starting to build up here a little bit? It's starting to take shape. Don't forget behind the ears. Doing a nice little modeling back here. And that's the nice thing about these brushes too, these water brushes, is you can scoop up a tiny bit, dab it off, and then do a blot. And the bristles you can see are pushing down and making an interesting pattern. So that's cool. And it does this natural pattern, which is good pattern for mottled skin on such a small scale. I like to just gentle dabs. Those are happy dabs. That's a happy mottled skin. And always try to break up those patterns. You don't want to have too uniform of those mottled skin. If that makes any sense. So you see how it's starting to darken up with just a simple color, just one simple color. And what I could do is I could go back in and I could add a little tiny bit of brown to darken that up a little bit. And that's going to help with the darkening it up and making it more of a difference, a different tone. Even though it's the same color, it could be a little darker by just adding just a brown to it. That'll help. But like I said, I want to try to keep this one more fleshy. I've always liked the darker tones and washes in zombies, rather than just kind of straight up fleshy. I like the darker washes, darker browns. So now I'm going to add a little bit of burnt umber here. Just a touch. And so I got a little tiny bit there, and there you can see how it got a little darker. Just a touch. So I've got my lights, my mid tones, and then now darker. I'm going to be pretty light-handed on the dark brown. I just want to get just a tiny differentiation between the two. See? And actually, that's a really dumb idea I got going on right now, because this is still a little wet. Now I'm going to take my finer brush here, and I'm just going to kind of go in here and focus on these spots that need to be dark so it doesn't get away from me. Recessed areas. And this is, I'm being a little, again, a little particular about where I'm hitting these little areas. I'm just hitting these wounds now to kind of darken them up a touch. And that's, now that's almost just straight up browns right there. I'm just hitting those little areas. And you know what? I like that glossed look. So I may go back in and gloss those up once this is all said and done. It's that crusty look. Although, I guess gloss isn't going to really make it crusty, so... More dried out, I guess, huh? Well, so I'm not sure yet what I'm doing there. Okay. So, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to dry this. And I feel that it's a little too dark of a contrast between the light skin and this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just oh so carefully and gently come back around with just the lightest of washes. I mean, I'm talking, I've got barely any of this light brown on my brush. In fact, if you'll notice, I wiped a good portion of it off. I'm wanting just the lightest little remnants of this to be on my brush so I can really control where this goes. And you, hopefully this picks up on camera and you can see what I'm talking about. But it's just the lightest of my wash. So I have total control of where I'm placing this, where I want that wash to go. Darken the sockets of those eyes a little bit more. And around this little area. And back into these little sockets. Around the ears again. Okay. I'm going to go back over that wound. See how I can just do kind of a swirling motion and it just completely blends. I really want to deepen in those craters and sockets around the back here and the traps underneath the occipital ridge. I'm gonna get a little bit more of my watered down darker brown now. Watercolor, water washes are an amazing thing. It is fantastic what you can do with them. I love doing the water washes. If you can master that, you can, it'll really help your painting along the way. And again, I don't claim to be an expert, but, I sure enjoy painting with these washes. They're great. You can achieve so much with just a simple wash. It's amazing. And if you don't panic, if something happens, then you'll be all right. I remember when I was first started washes, I got panicky and I started panicking because the water was going everywhere, and you just kind of learn to control. You learn to control. So I really want to drive this point home here that's... I'll be very careful in my handling of this. And I'm going to go ahead and fill my name in there. So now, looking at this at a certain angle, I'm not happy with some of the colors I got going here. So I'm gonna gently go around and just kind of blend, just lightly blend. You can come up inside the sockets, up in the nose. Right now I'm just going over it and I'm looking to see where there are bright spots, like lighter colored tones that could just be tied in just the tiniest bit. All right. Okay, so now, very carefully, I'm going to come in with black. Now, this is a scary spot right now. It can be, because if black is incredibly strong. So, you're going to want to get just the tiniest little bit. And it's better to get this watered down so much so that it you have more control over it. And you'll see what I'm talking about here. You just want to do the lightest of washes with this stuff. It's better to go super light and not get enough on there, and then to go back and add it, than to just glob it on and then you're kind of screwed, you know, because then you might have a difficult time getting it off of there. I'm not saying that you can't get it out or off, but better to, you know, just tread light. And that black is going to make those little areas that you've textured in there pop. So if you can just go just nice and light and easy, loose and flowing, you'll be all right. You'll achieve what it is that you're looking for. I want to darken up his nose. And I may do some sort of like a frostbite look. I'm not sure yet. I'm gonna play around with this one for 3 minutes. Okay, so let's now move on to our teeth, which I've got this antique white, which have no fear, my friends. It may seem bright right now, a bright white, but I'm going to tone this down quite a bit. And in fact, you can get away with using just the lightest wash on this as well. And you'll see what happens here when I go up in the eye. Super, super light wash. That's the name of the game. And the color that you've laid down underneath is actually going to work in your advantage, because it's a darker color, for one. And you can use that as a almost the if you're priming something, kind of gives you something to work off of that's a darker color. Go dark, work light. See how I've got just the slightest little bit going there. I think, all right, I want to add a little bit more color to those, because I'm going to go back over those teeth and everything else with like yellows and probably another brown wash to really nasty up those teeth. And let's get a little bit of yellow in there. Let's see, where did my yellow go? Do I not have any yellow out here? Wait for it. There it is. Again, controlled wash. Very, very, very thin wash. And if you get too much on there, don't panic. You can always either A, wipe it off, or go back over it with whatever you're looking to, you know, go back over it with. Browns or yellows or whatever. More yellows or more browns, tan colors, whatever kind of helps blend it in a little bit more. If that made any sense. I'm going to go back over these teeth with a little bit of brown. And I am going to blacken these up a little bit. So what you can also do is get your... I'm not going to put any pupils in. I'm just going to kind of do some blotches. I kind of like the splotchy, blotchy look. Different layers of browns, and then I'll go back over that with a simple wash of the white to kind of give it a little bit of opaqueness. So I see a couple little spots that I'm not happy with there, so I'm gonna tie those together with the browns. And if you can, it's always a good idea to try to keep your paints separate, so you're not mixing and matching all of your paints. That way you can, if you do forget something or if you need to go back and adjust something, you have all your palette here that you can work with. And mine's pretty sloppy, I guess, at this point, because they all are all on the same the same page here. But, other guys will have everything kind of locked, you know, like in separate little pallets and stuff, little containers, which is fine, too. But I just prefer to kind of keep them all arranged here on tin foil so I can do whatever I need to do my mixing and matching. You know what I mean? Okay, let's see here. So since I got my black out, I think I'm just going to go ahead and paint the front half here. Or the underside, I guess I should say. I can always blend that in a little better after the fact. Kind of just makes things look a little more professional. Guess I should probably try to keep this in frame, huh? Okay, so what I'm decided to do is I am going to, I love the black goo that runs, so I'm going to potentially cover up most of these teeth, and I'm going to just put some black goo in there. And I want it to be running down his... chin, So I'm actually going to lighten these up a little bit. And I'm going to wash those out so you see those teeth. See how I kind of overdid it with the paints and the black, but then I went back and just quickly wiped them out. So yes, it's covered, but you can still see the teeth now. So I'm going to go ahead and try to splatter some of this around. And if you use the actual wash in there, it helps it to flow, of course. And so there you've got a nice big black goo running up. And I'm just going to run a little bit down this side. Okay, so now, this is one of my favorite parts, and I hope I don't get this stuff everywhere, but we'll see. Is now, I'm going to get a little bit of that water on there, and see all that black? So now I'm just going to come in, and I'm going to just gently spritz the face. So it gives me a nice, oops, and I just put my finger in my paints, so that's no good. There we go. I don't want to do too much. Just want to get a nice little black coat. All right. Black thumb. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add just a little bit more, spread this around a little bit so it looks like he's smeared it all over the place. And even up into his nose a little bit. Like he's just been chomping down, biting somebody. With that nasty black goo. See, I told you I was going to come back and blacken up that nose. A nice black goo. Okay, looking good, huh? All right, so here's what I'm going to do. Actually, I'm not a big fan of how this pooled here at the bottom, so I'm going to just kind of try to blend it out so it looks like it. Pooled down in this area a little more. There we go. So as soon as this is dry, which looks like it's getting to be in that that position now. Actually, you know what? I think this would be unnatural. I guess I would want to darken that up too. Oh, and you know what else? I want to darken this eye up. There we go. And I think I want to darken in around there too. Not too much. Just to make that white socket, make that eye pop out. Okay. So, I'm going to hit this up. Well, wait. See, as an artist, it's little things like that that just drive me crazy. I just can't quite seem to let it go. Don't you know? All right. That's it. I'm done. All right. So now, I'm done. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pause my camera here. I'm going to go and I'm going to matte seal this with my matte finish. And I will come back and we will gloss this up. And we're going to call this one done. I'm going to, of course, keep touching this. I cannot help it. I'm very sorry here. But it possesses me. Little things I see. Okay. I went ahead and gave a good matte finish seal job to this, and now we are going to go ahead and gloss this, which this is probably one of my favorite parts, because this is what really makes this piece pop, or any pieces really in general. Something about gloss is just disturbing. It will make a piece that is already messed up that much more disturbing when there's a gloss shine to it. I don't know, man. There's just something crazy about this shiny, gooey gloss that just people don't want to touch it. People don't want to be around it, which is awesome. I love that. I love gloss and goo and blood and guts. See how that is making all the difference. Go easy on the gloss. You can do multiple layers, build them up, or you'll get these weird little bubbles like right there. And we'll now work our way down. Down the neck. Yeah. And again, the beauty of a zombie is there's no rhyme or reason, really, with zombies. I mean, you can do pretty much anything you want. I could go back and gloss up those wounds if I wanted, you know, like all these little areas. But I think less is more in this case. You know, you've got your dried out zombie look, and then you've got the all this goo and bright gloss here that is boom, accentuating the disgustingness and all the nastiness that's going on in this piece. And I always try to get those little little spatters off to the side. Okay, now comes the eye, and I'm just going to very carefully, very gently go up and hit that eye. And this one, my friends, is done. I'm not sure what we're at time-wise. I'm sure we're probably getting close to 45 minutes to an hour, I'm assuming. But I think it's worth it. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, that is it. That is the painting of a zombie bust. Thank you guys so much for checking this video out. I appreciate it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down there in the comment section below. I do my very best to try to get to everybody and answer all and you know, talk with everybody that takes the time to check me out and talk to me. So I appreciate each and every single one of you. You guys are awesome. Also, feel free to check me out on Instagram, Toby Wayne Studios over there. And as always, until the very next video, I will see you later.